Still now, American College of Cardiology guidelines has not been changed. Still a class one indication for embolic protection device used in saphenous vein graft intervention. That means that you should use when technically feasible. But my research and recommendation changed the European Society of Cardiology guidelines 2018, and they downgraded this recommendation from class 1 to class 2A. That means that it's reasonable to use it, but you should not have to use for all comers. The practical aspects of this, that basically you don't have to use this embolic protection device in all cases, like not routine use for every patient, but you can select for high risk patients that really have high burden of possible distal embolization, and you can really get maybe benefited in those cases, especially the acute coronary syndrome patients or old grafts, all of this. There are a lot of scenario that you cannot really even use the embolic protection device, like aortostal lesions, and if you have a smaller size vessels or bigger size vessels, if you have a very tortuous anatomy, and so on. Multiple studies and registry data showed that approximately 50% of the cases you cannot even use. Even if you want to use, you cannot use this device. And in United States, overall use of embolic protection device is 21% anyway. So, and even if you use it, it does not protect all the time. 10% of the cases, even if you use it, still you will have no reflow and incidence of operative myocardial infarctions. There's a lot of trials has been done on this area. The first study started in 2006, basically. There are 7 randomized trials has been done so far. And there are some smaller studies, there are some bigger studies. The largest trial so far has been published last year, 2018, called ISR-CABG trial, 610 patients. And that study shows that there is no difference in the outcomes and cardiovascular outcomes like all-cause mortality, stent thrombosis, repeat revascularization. There is no difference between the drug-eluting versus bare metal stents. But this trial, when they looked at it 1 year data, like earlier trial data, and it showed that there was a benefit, but long-term there is no benefit. There is another study called DIVA trial, D-I-V-A trial, that published in 2017, and that study also showed for short term and long term, there is no benefit of using the DS over BMS. So they looked at all-cause mortality and also target vessel failure is their primary outcome. And target vessel failure included the target lesion revascularization and MI and repeat revascularization. But it did not show any difference between the bare metal and drug-eluting stents. This trial looked at also short-term and long-term data. Both short-term and long-term data did not make any difference. So I think that is kind of equivocal right now. You have to individualize when which DS versus, or you want to use the BMS. From my studies, of course, I presented these trials and data. I think the highlights from the DS versus BMS would be you should individualize the, your use of the DS. You have to look at the cost, like DS is higher cost than BMS. So, and also you have to look for DAPT compliance and DAPT tolerance, meaning that a lot of patients cannot use long-term dual antiplatelet therapy. They may have more bleeding risk. So those patients may be more favorable to use the BMS versus DS. And some countries have higher price of the DS. So all those countries you have to individualize whether you want a BMS versus DS, because both are equally effective. And from the embolic protection device, European guidelines already has been changed, and people are following that. There will be new guidelines coming for ACC this year, and hopefully they will follow the European guidelines and hope that will change to class 2A. And I think that even if you use, keep it as class 2A, you don't have, it's not stopping you to use it. you still can use it because class 2 means it's reasonable to use it, but they are not mandating you to use the embolic pressure device in all cases. I think those are the two takeaways from these two recent studies and trials.